Hello, another tip of entering dates or filling dates with a dynamic array. So what we have here, you have one date and you have another date, and then you would like to list all the dates in between, including the ones that is start date and the end date, dynamically, in such a way that if you change the start date, your list changes, and if you change the end date, then your list changes as well. I'm going to show you how to do this in this video. So like, subscribe, get ready. So how do we pull it off? We have two dates, the beginning date or the start date and the end date. The first critical concept to understand is dates in Excel are numbers. Let me show you. I'm going to create a little formula that will reference the date on the left-hand side in column B, and I will do it one more time. So these are the same dates as these, and if I change the format from the date format into, let's say, the general format, which is, as you might know, Control-Shift-Tilde. Control-Shift-Tilde. So now I see a couple of numbers, like sequential numbers. Those are the numbers associated with those dates. And the dates in Excel are numbers. Well, starting with January 1st, 1900. So if I put 1/1/1900 and change it into the general format, then it will be day one. So these two dates are 45/235, 45/243. We are going to pull it off by first figuring out how many days we have in that range. And of course, you can take one date, the later date, and subtract the earlier date. But there's a special function for that. It's called days. Let me show you how it works. So days, first you specify the end date, and then comma, and the second argument is to specify the start date. And now I'm done. I'm going to hit Control Enter. So that's 11 days, right? So 11 days. Now we can use that number of days, that 11, and feed it into the sequence function, which you have seen before if you watched my previous videos on similar topics. So if I put sequence here, and let's say I click on this one, it will fill 11 rows with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And if this number changes, then I will get a different number, a different sequence. The length of the sequence will change. Now, what is beautiful about the sequence function? It is actually more versatile than filling 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because you can add additional arguments. And you see that there are some, there's one mandatory argument, which is the number of rows, which was 11. But then we have the number of columns, which I don't need. So I'm going to put comma one more time. I'm going to ignore the columns. And you see that the start and step. So start, if I make the start as my start date, and remember, a date is a number, right? So it will basically be, the start will be this number, 45,232. And press Enter, you see that I got a sequence of 11 numbers starting with the first number, with the first start date. Well, all I need to do, of course, these are not formatted as dates. All I need to do now is just format them as dates, because dates are numbers. So I don't need to do anything fancy like a date function and all that stuff, which is also doable, but this is much easier than that. So I'm gonna apply a long date format to this column. So now I have my dates. And one thing to notice, however, that you see that it ends November 12th, and my last day, the end date, is actually November 13th. So it is, it's by design that way. So all I need to do is add plus one for the reference to B3. And now I should have all the dates filled in. And if I change this, so let's say 11/5/2023, you see that I get a dynamic list of dates covering the entire range between the start date and the end date, including the start date and the end date. Now, of course, we don't really need this separate calculation of days, the difference between the two dates. I'm going to copy that calculation, as I always do, and I'm going to replace the reference to B3 with that calculation. And voila, this is just one formula that returns a dynamic array, and that dynamic array is listing all the dates between the start date and the end date, including the start date and the end date. And I can delete this formula, and I can also get rid of these two. So now we have a little elegant solution of dynamically filling a range of dates based on their frontiers, you know, on the start date and the end date. And if I put, let's say, control semicolon here, that's the today's date, and I'm going to put, let's say, 1-1-1-1-2023, I get that many days filled dynamically with the dynamic array, thanks to the amazing sequence function. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed it, then like it, subscribe it. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.